Hi students, in previous lecture we have seen properties of logarithms and in today's lecture we will be discussing problems on that logarithms. Okay, we will start, but before watching this video, first once again you go through each and every property what we discussed in previous lecture and you see all those properties and then start watching this video. It will become very easy for you. Okay, we will start. We will be starting with the basic problems of logarithms. Let us see all these problems by using just a simple properties. Right. Find the values of all these. First one, you see, it is log base 2, log base 3 into log of 512 to the base 2. Observe this, it is log base 2 into log base 3 into log of 512, 512 can be written as 2 power 9 to the base 2. Now observe this logarithm, it is of the form log a power m to the base x. And we know log a power m to the base x is equal to m log a to the base x. Therefore, this 9 will come here. It is equal to log base 2 into log 9 to the base 3 into log 2 to the base 2. But of course, log 2 to the base 2 is equal to 1. It is equal to again log base 2 into log of this 9 can be written as 3 square to the base 3 into 1. Now again it is of the form log a power m to the base x can be written as m log a to the base x. It is equal to log, I mean of course it is a base 2 into 2 times of log 3 to the base 3. What is log 3 to the base 3? 1 only. It is equal to, I will get log 2 to the base 2 whose value is equal to 1. Simple one, here I have written 512 as 2 power 9, this 9 will come here and log 2 to the base 2 is equal to 1, now log 9 to the base 3. Again this 9 can be written as a 3 square, again this 2 come here by using this property, log 3 to the base 3 it is equal to 1, again log 2 to the base 2, log 2 to the base 2 equal to 1. Okay, now second one let us see, here this one log base 7. Log of root of 7 into root of 7 into root of 7 to the base 7. First, let us simplify this value. See here, some of you definitely might be comfortable to simplify that. Anyway, I will explain. You know, root 7 means it is 7 power 1 by 2. Root 7 into root 7 means it is equal to 7 root 7 whole power 1 by 2 is equal to 7 power 1 by 2 into 7 power 1 by 2 whole power 1 by 2 means 7 power 1 by 4, it is equal to 7 power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4. Similarly, if I take root of 7 root of 7 root of 7, it will be 7 power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 it will become. So now let us see this. It is equal to log base 7 into log of 7 power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 to the base 7. It is equal to log base 7 into log of 7 power 8 is the LCM, 4 plus 2 6 plus 1 7 by 8 to the base 7. Observe this, again it is of the form log a power m to the base x. Log a power m to the base x means m log a to the base x. It is equal to log base 7, this 7 by 8 will come here. What is log 7 to the base 7 value equal to 1. Now it is of the form again log a by b. Log a by b can be written as log a minus log b. it is equal to log 7 to the base 7 minus log 8 to the base 7 is equal to 1 minus log of, again 8 can be written as 2 cube to the base 7. That is a most simplified form I am writing. Of course, you can write it as 1 minus log 8 to the base 7. Even I can write 1 minus log 2 cube to the base 7. Final simplification is 1 minus 3 log 2 to the base 7 is the value. This part is simplification, I mean finding this one, and it is the value of that 1 minus 3 log 2 to the base 7. Okay. Next, coming to this one, log root of 5 into root of 5 into root of 5 and so on infinite terms to the base 5. Some of you must have seen this type of expressions in lower classes. Anyway, first let me handle this one, then we will see this problem. How to find this value? You see, root of 5 into root of 5 into root of 5 and so on infinite terms, I will take it is equal to x. My intention is to find value of this one first. Squaring x square equal to 5 into 1 root will get cancelled. Root of 5, root of 5, root of 5 and so on infinite terms. Again, what is the value of this one? Value of this one is equal to value of this only, that is x. That implies I can write x square equal to 5x. If I bring this side, x into x minus 5 equal to 0 implies x equal to 0, x equal to 5. But x equal to root of 5 into root of 5 and so on, positive real numbers only, it cannot be 0. Therefore, x not equal to 0. And what is the value that should be taken here? X equal to 5 only. X equal to means that is root of and so on. Therefore, value of this is equal to 5. Hence, that problem will become log 5 to the base 5 is equal to 1. Therefore, our value of this log of root of 5 and so on is log 5 to the base 5 equal to 1. It is one way to handle this problem. Other way, what we have simplified that one, no? In that way also we can write, we can simplify this one. Observe this. If I take this value, it is 5 power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 16 plus and so on infinite terms I will get. If you have idea about geometric progression, then you can simplify this value. If you do not know about GP means, it is the way where you can understand simple. If it is infinite GP whose first term is equal to A and common ratio R, A by 1 minus R is S infinity. Therefore, it is 5 power, what is first term? 1 by 2. Here A is 1 by 2 and common ratio means second term by first term means that also 1 by 2 only. Therefore, here A is 1 by 2, R equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, value of sum means 1 by 2 by 1 minus 1 by 2. 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2 only, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 will get cancelled, it is equal to 5. But you can go with this one only when you know formula to find sum of infinite GP. And of course, that GP is valid only when common ratio is less than 1. Of course, here it is less than 1, we can calculate that. And next, coming to this fourth one, log tan 1 into log tan 2 into log tan 3 and so on log tan 89. Observe this. Tan 1 positive, tan 2 positive and so on, tan 89 positive, all are defined. A simple logic here. observe this while writing log tan 1, log tan 2, log tan 3 and so on, log tan 9. No? Here somewhere in the middle this term is there, what it is, log tan 45 degrees. Log tan 45 degrees, a term is there in between this, log tan 44, log tan 45 and so on, log tan 89. And of course, it is multiplying with this product only. And what is a tan 45 degrees value? You know, you studied that one in 10th class, 1. Therefore, here log tan 45 means 1 you will get. But we know logarithm of 1 to any base equal to 0, therefore this value equal to 0. What is the meaning here? Some terms are there, multiplied by log tan 45 means 0 into some other terms are there. Log tan 1, log tan 2 and so on, log tan 44 will be there. Into log tan 45 means log 1 equal to 0 into some other value is there. But anyhow, it is finite, multiplied by 0 means what you will get answer for this is 0. Hope you understood all these 4 problems. We will move to the next problem. Right, next one, given log a plus b by 2 to the base e is equal to half log a to the base e plus log b to the base e, then find a relation between a and b. Right, here it is log a plus b by 2 to the base e is equal to half, it is log a to the base e plus log b to the base e. We know log a plus log b equal to log a b. It is log a b to the base e. Now you observe here what I will do. This 1 by 2 is there, no cross multiplication. This I will write here. And now it is of the form m log x. M log x can be written as log x power m. Therefore, this 2 I can write here. It is whole square. Now, it is of the form log x to the base e equal to log y to the base e, then x equal to e. That implies a plus b by 2 whole square is equal to a b, or a plus b whole square minus 4ab equal to 0 implies a minus b whole square equal to 0. Square of a number equal to 0 means that number should be equal to 0. That implies A equal to B is the relation. It is the relation between A and B. Very simple result. And next, this one is log 2 to the base 7 equal to given M. It is the simplest form, these two numbers. Both are prime numbers only, no factors for that. That is the simplest. Now, they are asking log 28 to the base 49 in terms of m. This value in terms of m means we must express this in terms of, I mean, log 2 to the base 7. Here you see, try to write prime factorization of this one and this one, log of 28, 7 into 4. It is 7 into 2 square. Here it is 49 means 7 square I can write. You observe here, it is of the form log AB to the base X. It is log A to the base X plus log B to the base X. I will write log 7 to the base 7 square plus log 2 square to the base 7 square. It is equal to 7 power 1 to 7 square means 1 by 2 into log 7 to the base 7 plus it is 2 by 2 into log 2 to the base 7. Log 7 to the base 7 is 1, 1 by 2 plus 1 into log 2 to the base 7 equal to m only, it is 1 into m equal to 1 plus 2m by 2 will be the value. Therefore, this is the answer. See this, find the value or simplify. 81 whole power 1 by log 3 to the base 5 plus 27 whole power log 36 to the base 9 plus 3 power 4 by log 9 to the base 7. Here mostly I am going to use one result. It is what? A power log x to the base a equal to x. So try to write these, terms in terms of a power log x to the base a. That is the key point here. It is equal to 81 whole power. It is 1 by log 3 to the base 5. 1 by log 3 to the base 5 can be written as log 5 to the base 3. It is a property. Base change rule. What is the base change rule? Log a to the base b can be written as 1 by log b to the base a. This what I have used. Plus 27 whole power. This can be written as 6 square to the base 3 square. I have written 36 is there 6 square and 9 3 square plus 3 power 4 into log 9 to the base 7 in the denominator, in the numerator it will become log 7 to the base 9. Nothing I did, just log a to the base b 1 by log b to the base a I have used. That's all, that is only. It is equal to, observe here, base 3, this one also I can write in terms of 3. What is 81 as 3 power 4 I can write? Whole power log 5 to the base 3 plus here log a power m to the base x power m means this 2 by 2 will get cancelled. It is log 6 to the base 3. Here base 3, this 27 also we can write as power of 3. It is 3 cube whole power. It is log 6 to the base 3. I am not writing 2 by 2 here because anyhow that 2 by 2 will become 1. Plus it is 3 power 4 into log 7 to base 3 square I can write. Right, okay. One more step I will write. It is a power m whole power n. It is 3 power 4 log 5 to the base 3 plus again a power m whole power n 3 power 3 log 6 to the base 3 plus here log x to the base a power n means 1 by n I can write. Therefore, here it is 3 power, it will become 4 by 2 log 7 to the base 3 is equal to 3 power m log x to the base a means this can be written as log 5 power 4 to the base 3. It is log 5 power 4 to the base 3 plus 3 power 3 log 6 to the base 3 can be written as log 6 power 3 to the base 3 plus 3 power, this 2 times will get cancelled, it is log 7 square to the base 3. Now, it is 3, it is 3. It is of the form a power x to the base a, it is equal to x only. It is of the form a power log x to the base a, it is equal to x only. Therefore, I am going to use that. It is equal to 5 power 4 plus 6 power 3 plus 7 square. 5 power 4, see here, 25 into 25, 625, 6 cube 216 plus 49, it is equal to 890 will be the answer. Okay, we will see that problem. Here log 5 to the base 4 equal to a given, log 6 to the base 5 equal to given b, then log 2 to the base 3 they are asking in terms of a comma b. Observe here 5 to 4 and 6 to 5, if I take product it will be useful, AB if I take, it is equal to log 5 to the base 4 into log 6 to the base 5. By using base change rule, it is equal to log 6 to the base 4. 5 will get given. It is equal to log 2 into 3 to the base 2 square. Because I want log 2 to the base 3 is equal to 1 by 2 times of this 1 by 2 I am writing, log 2 to the base 2 plus log 3 to the base 2 is equal to 1 by 2 times of log 2 to the base 2 is 1 only, logarithm of any number to the base, log 3 to the base 2. Yes, I want that value. That implies 2AB is equal to 1 plus log 3 to the base 2 or log 3 to the base 2, 2AB minus 1. But I need log 2 to the base 3. Therefore, log 2 to the base 3 means reciprocal of this, it is 1 by 2AB minus 1. Hence, it is the answer. Log 2 to the base 3 equal to 1 by 2AB minus 1. Show that the number log 7 to the base 2 is an irrational number. Right. This model also, even this one also previous entrance question. Log 7 to the base 2 is options given, integer, irrational, rational, none of these options are given. See, we want to show that it is an irrational number. Let us assume that it is rational and we will prove that that is a contradiction. Then also we can say a number which is not rational is a rational number. We will take. Suppose log 7 to the base 2 is a rational number. It is a rational number means it must be of the form P by Q, where P comma Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. By using logarithmic definition, 7 can be written as 2 power P by Q. Raised to the power Q on both sides, 7 power Q is equal to 2 power P. Here P and Q are integers, means I can say this side it is an odd number, and whereas this side it is an even number, because of 2 power and 7 power. Therefore, what got here, it is 7 power Q equal to 2 power P means here it is odd number equal to even number. For any values of P comma Q, because left side odd and right side even, these two never be equal. And this is because of our supposition is there no log 7 to the base 2 is a rational number. Because we have chosen this as a rational, we got a contradiction. Therefore, hence I can write log 7 to the base 2 is not a rational number, implies it is an irrational number. It is an irrational number. It is a contradiction. It is a contradiction. Implies our supposition is wrong, hence log 7 to the base 2 is an irrational number. It is a different model. The number log 3 to the base 20 lies in the interval 1 by 4, 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 2 and so on. See here, we need log 3 to the base 20. I am taking 20 here. As a power of 3, I am observing the near values for 20, which are less than 20 and which are greater than 20. If I take 3, 3 square, 3 cube, 3 power 4, it is 3 only, it is 9, it is 27, it is 81. Therefore, 20 lies between 9 and 27. 20 lies between 9 and 27 means yes, I can write it is 3 square less than 20 is less than 3 cube. Hope you understood. What are the nearest powers of 3 where this 20 lies in between? Here 3 power 1, 3, 3 square 9, 3 cube 27, 3 4 81. Here 20 means it lies between 9 and 27. Therefore, I can write inequality 3 square less than 20 less than 3 cube. Why I have taken powers of 3 only? Because I need log 3 to the base 20. Now, I will take logarithms to this inequality to the base 3. Take logarithms to base 3. Base 3 means it is an increasing function only. This inequality will not change. That inequality will remain same. That implies log 3 square to the base 3 is less than log 20 to the base 3 is less than log 3 cube to the base 3. If I would have taken this base between a number lies between 0 to 1, then this inequality might have changed. But because base 3 a number greater than 1, increasing function only, that inequality is there, no, less than will remain less than only. Now 3 square to the base 3 means this 2 will come here, it is 2 into log 3 to the base 3 is 1, is less than, it is log 20 to the base 3, is less than, it is 3. But I want log 3 to the base 20, not log 20 to the base 3. And you know, 2 log 20 to the base 3 positive, this one also positive, all are positive only, and we have seen basics. A less than b means if both have same sign, 1 by a greater than 1 by b. Even if I take less than c, I can take 1 by a greater than 1 by b greater than 1 by c, provided all these three have same signs. That implies I can write 1 by 2 greater than 1 by log 20 to the base 3 greater than 1 by 3. That is, here you see 1 by 2 greater than 1 by log 20 to the base 3 is nothing but log 3 to the base 20 is greater than 1 by 3. That is 1 by 3 less than log 3 to the base 20 less than 1 by 2. Hence, log 3 to the base 20 lies in the interval 1 by 3 to 1 by 2. That implies log 3 to the base 20 value lies in the interval 1 by 3 comma 1. That is, this is correct, 1 by 3 to 1. Hope you understood this one. It is not difficult one. Next problems we are going to use base change rule. That is, you know, log a to the base b can be written as 1 by log b to the base a. Or that implies I can write log a to the base b into log b to the base a is equal to. That is, you see, whenever log a to the base b is there means I can write log a to the base x into log x to the base b. It is what? Base change rule. Log a to the base b can be written as log a to the base x into log x to the base b. Or it is equal to log a to the base x by log b to the base x. Therefore, whenever it is of the form log a to the base b is there, we can write it as log a to the base x into log x to the base b, or log a to the base x by log b to the base x we can write. Therefore, suppose if it is given log 2 to the base 3 into log 3 to the base 4, if I want the value of this one, can be written as log 2 by log 3 into log 3 by log 4 I can write. This will get cancelled, it is equal to log 2 by log 4 can be written as log 2 to the base 4. What is the value here? 2 square I can write, it is 1 by 2 times of log 2 to the base 2 is equal to 1 by 2.
Yes, I am going to use this base change rule. Whenever log a to the base b is there, means I can write log a to the base x into log x to the base b. Or log a to the base x into log x to the base b is there, means I will write log a to the base b. Therefore, in general, if you take log a to the base b into log b to the base c into log c to the base a, if it is, now here b, b cancel, c, c cancel, means if you write log a by log b, it is equal to what you will get, log a to the base a, and of course log a to the base a equal to 1. Yes, this concept I am going to use for the next problems. So remember, log a to the base b, log a to the base x, log x to the base b, base change rule. Or whenever it is of the form, means I can write it is log a to the base b. Or log a to the base b can be written as log a to the base x by log b to the base x. Whenever if I require to change base of this logarithm, I can change that base as log a to the base x by log b to the base x, or log a to x, log x to base b. Yes, we will see this one. Here a power x is equal to b. It is of the form n equal to a power x. That is, by using definition, x is equal to log b to the base a. Similarly, b power y equal to c. Therefore, y is equal to log c to the base b, and c power z is equal to a implies z is equal to log a to the base c. Now, therefore, x, y, z is equal to, I want value of x, y, z, it is log b to the base a into log c to the base b into log a to the base c. Now you see, it is b and b, it is c and c, therefore it can be written as log a to the base a is equal to 1. Just now I have explained that concept, base change rule. This one direct only, you see here, 4, 2, 3, 5, 4, 6, 5, 7, 6, 8, 7, 9, 8. This 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 will get cancelled, log 4 by log 3 if you write. It is equal to finally log 9 to the base 3. It is equal to log 3 square to the base 3 is equal to 2 will be the answer. This one important model. If x equal to log bc to the base a, y equal to log ca to the base b, z equal to log ab to the base c, then show that 1 by 1 plus x plus 1 by 1 plus y plus 1 by 1 plus z is equal to. First, look here, x is equal to log bc to the base a is there. I need 1 plus x, therefore 1 plus x is equal to 1 plus log bc to the base a. This as a single term I want to write, this 1 can be written as log a to the base a plus log bc to the base a. Why I am writing to the base a means here, because it is a base a. Now, it is of the form log x plus log y equal to log x y, it is equal to log a b c to the base a. It is what? 1 plus x. Similarly, if I take 1 plus y is equal to 1 plus log c a to the base b, it is equal to log b to the base b plus log c a to the base b is equal to log a b c to the base b. And z plus 1 is equal to 1 plus log ab to the base c, it is equal to 1 means can be written as log c to the base b plus log ab to the base c, it is equal to log abc to the base c. Now you observe, 1 plus x log abc to the base a, it is abc to the base b, ABC to the base C. Bases are different, whereas number same. If bases are same, if you add, you can take simplification of that one. Bases are different means you cannot add. Therefore, if I take reciprocal of these, base will become ABC for all those. Therefore, simplification is possible. That's why, therefore, I will consider 1 by 1 plus x plus 1 by 1 plus y plus 1 by 1 plus z. It is equal to log a to base abc plus log b to base abc plus log C2 base ABC. Now ABC base is same. It is of the form log x plus log y plus log z can be written as log xyz. It is equal to log of ABC to the base ABC, which is equal to 1. Hence the result 1 by 1 plus x plus 1 by 1 plus y plus 1 by 1 plus z is equal to 1. Important model. One more problem of this type we will be doing. Right, next problem, it is very important model. Of course, previous entrance question this one. If log x by b minus c equal to log y by c minus a equal to log z by a minus b. Here you see base not given means it is to the base 10 you can take or to the same base whatever it is you take, it is equal to a or abc already we have used. Log x to the base p, log y to the base p, log z to the base p. Not given means base is same for all logarithms. If log x by b minus c equal to log y by c minus a equal to log z by a minus b, then these are the options given. Which of the following are correct? X, y, z equal to 1, x power a into y power b into z power c equal to 1, this third option equal to 1 or fourth option, these are the options given. Multi correct answers. See here, how to proceed this type of problems is, here given log x by b minus c is equal to log y by c minus a is equal to log z by a minus b, I will take it is equal to some p, or I will take it is equal to some k. Now, log x is equal to k times of b minus c, log y is equal to k times of c minus a, log z is equal to k times of a minus b. Right. Now, you see, if I want x, y, z, I must take log x plus log y plus log z. Therefore, I will take log x plus log y plus log z is equal to what you will get? K common b minus c plus c minus a plus a minus b. All these terms will get cancelled equal to 0. That implies log x, y, z is equal to 0. Log x, y, z equal to 0 means x, y, z must be equal to 1. So, it is what for first one? First one is correct. X, y, z equal to 1. Next. Let us see second result. We need x power a, y power b into z power c value. Observe this. I will take x power a into y power b into z power c equal to some p I will take. Take logarithms on both sides because I know log x, log y, log z. If I take logarithms on both sides, log x power a into y power b into z power c is equal to log p. Here it is log x power a plus log y power b plus log z power c is equal to log. Now it is of the form log x power m log a. It is a log x plus b log y plus c log z is equal to log p. Now a into what is log x k times of b minus c? It is k into b minus c plus b into k times of c minus a plus c into log z, it is k times of a minus b is equal to log p. Therefore, I will take k common here, ab minus ac plus bc minus ba plus ca minus cb is equal to log p. Therefore, here ab cancel, here it is bc minus bc, ca cancel, that is log p equal to 0. log p equal to 0 implies p must be equal to 1. What is p? X power a, y power b, z power c. That implies x power a into y power b into z power c equal to 1. Therefore, second option also correct. X, y, z equal to 1, x power a into y power b into z power c equal to 1 means these two are equal. Therefore, fourth option also correct. X, y, z equal to x power a into y power b into z power c also correct. Now, we will see third one. What is the value of x power b plus c, y power c plus a, z power a plus b? I will erase this one. Now, let us see third option. Here also, I will take x power b plus c into y power c plus a into z power a plus b is equal to some lambda. I will take, I want value of lambda. Same like this option only, I will take logarithms on both sides. Logarithms on both sides means directly log x, y, z, log x plus log y plus log z, again b plus c will come here. Therefore, straight away step I am writing b plus c into log x plus c plus a into log y plus a plus b into log z is equal to log lambda. That implies b plus c into log x, k times of b minus c, plus c plus a into log y, it is k times of c minus a, plus a plus b into log z, it is k times of a minus b, is equal to log lambda. I will take k common, b plus c into b minus c, b square minus c square plus c square minus a square minus b square is equal to log lambda. This b square will get cancelled, a square cancel, c square cancel. That implies log lambda equal to 0. Log lambda equal to 0 means lambda equal to 1. But what is lambda? Lambda is nothing but this one only. X power b plus c into y power c plus a into z power a plus b, that is equal to 1. Hence, even third option also correct only. Therefore, all these four results are true. Previous entrance question, this one, important model. Hope you understood this one. Now, next modal problems, an equation is given in terms of x. They are asking solution of this equation. Means find the value of x for which this is true. Yes, here you see. It is of the form log n to the base a. Therefore, n means I can write log of x plus 2 to the base 3 is equal to 2 power 0. The 2 power 0 is 1 only. Again, x plus 2 is equal to 3 power 1, that is equal to 3. Therefore, x is equal to 1 will be the solution. That's all. And even next one you see. Yes, it is our n. This can be written as log of root of x square plus 5 plus x to the base 5 is equal to 7 power 0 is equal to 1. Again, root over x square plus 5 plus x is equal to 5 power 1. Again, squaring this one to find value of x, x square plus 5 plus x is equal to 25, x square plus x minus 20 equal to 0. It is x plus 5 into x minus 4 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 5 comma x equal to 4. Check minus 5, is it a solution or not? Yes, minus 5 plus 5 cancel, it is 5 square, it is 5 only. Log 5 to the base 5 equal to 1, log 1 to the base 7 equal to 0, hence both are correct only. Even for 4, 4 plus 5, 9. 9 plus 16, 25, root 25, 5 only, yes, it is true. Therefore, these are the solutions. But of course, after finding the solutions, you need to check whether those values of x will satisfy the given condition or not. Actually, are they in the domain of that function or not? Yes, both are possible. And here x equal to 1, if you take 3 to the base 3, yes, it is, I mean, possible. These are the solutions. Next model, inequalities, you see. Find a set of real values of x for which this log of to the x square minus 6x plus 12 to the base 1 by 2 greater than or equal to minus 2. Here base 1 by 2, it lies between 0 to 1. In previous lecture we have seen whenever base lies between 0 to 1 means it is a decreasing function. That implies I can write x square minus 6x plus 12 less than or equal to 1 by 2 whole power minus 2 it will become, because it is a decreasing base less than 1 by 2, I mean base less than 1. That is x square minus 6x plus 12 less than or equal to 2 square means 4, x square minus 6x plus 8 less than or equal to 0. That is x minus 2 into x minus 4 less than or equal to 0 implies solution is it is of the form x minus alpha into x minus beta less than or equal to 0. X belong to 2 comma 4 will be the solution set. Therefore, it is the solution set. But of course, here you see while solving these type of problems, you need to check. I have taken this inequality, okay. And you need to take care of this one. When it is defined, only when it is greater than 0, that is x square minus 6x plus 12 should be greater than 0. Even if I find solution, these solutions must satisfy this one. If you observe this inequality means a discriminant, if you see here b square minus 4ac 48 which is less than 0. Discriminant less than 0 and coefficient of x square positive means therefore it is greater than 0 for all x belong to capital R. Hence there is no problem with this one. Whatever the solution you will get, that will be the required solution. Suppose some of these values are not there in this, means you should delete those values because that must be in the domain. It is the domain of the function. Okay, let us see next one. Here log of x minus 1 to the base 0.04 greater than or equal to log of x minus 1 to the base 0.2. Here it is log x minus 1 to the base I will write 0.2 whole square greater than or equal to log of x minus 1 to the base 0.2. Here I have written 0.04 as 0.2 whole square. Now you see this. By using the property log x to the base a power m, no, 1 by m, this 2 will come here, this 1 by 2 I will write here, cross multiplication. Now this 2 I can write here also. Hope you can understand that one easy only. This log x to the base a power n, it is 1 by n. This 1 by 2, because it is a positive real number, I can take cross multiplication here. It is again m log a means log a power m I can write, it is whole square. Therefore, finally you observe this, log x minus 1 to the base 0.2 greater than or equal to log x minus 1 whole square to the base 0.2. Now, base of this logarithm is 0.2 means which lies between 0 to 1, hence it is a decreasing function. If you want to eliminate or remove this logarithm, then inequality will change. That implies here I can write x minus 1 less than or equal to x minus 1 whole square. Or that implies x minus 1 whole square minus of x minus 1 greater than or equal to 0, I will take x minus 1 common, x minus 1 greater than or equal to 0, that is x minus 1 into x minus 2 greater than or equal to 0. It is of the form x minus alpha into x minus beta greater than or equal to 0. You know wavy curve, here it is 1, 2, here positive, negative, because coefficient of x square positive. I need values of x where it is positive means minus infinity to 1 union 2 to infinity. Hence, x belong to minus infinity comma 1 closed 2 to infinity I have written. But you observe this. What is the domain? Domain means where this logarithmic function is defined.
because here x minus 1 is there, that x minus 1 should be greater than 0 implies x greater than 1 is the primary condition to define that logarithmic function.
Therefore, in this solution set, you see whether x greater than 1 or not. Yes, if I take this minus infinity to 1, no, this will not satisfy. If you take any value in this interval, that will become negative, where logarithm is not defined. And this interval, if you take 2 to infinity complete, it is greater than 0, greater than 1. Hence, I can write solution set is x belong to closed 2 to infinity will be the solution. Hope you understood this one. See, one or two times you go through this one and try to understand that one. Simple inequality only, here it is, see, base lies between 0 to 1. Hence, it is a decreasing function. Decreasing function means, I have explained, whenever x less than y, f of x will become greater than f of y. For logarithmic function, whenever base lies between 0 to 1, it is a decreasing function, and base greater than 1 means it is an increasing function with graph we discussed in previous lecture. But very important model even this one also, it is previous JE question. Here you may get a small doubt in this case, sir, here logarithm is there on both sides because base 0.2, you have removed this logarithm by taking this inequality greater than or equal to less than or equal to. But here minus 2 is there, but you have taken base 1 by 2 less than 1, you have written in this way, how we can? Yes, we can write here, this minus 2 is there, no, this minus 2 can be written as log 1 by 2 whole power minus 2 to the base 1 by 2. Can I write it? Yes. This minus 2 come here. That minus 2 times of log 1 by 2 to the base 1 by 2 only. Therefore, this minus 2 can be written as minus 2 into log 1 by 2 to the base 1 by 2. That is log 1 by 2 whole power minus 2 to the base 1 by 2. Therefore, this minus 2 can be written in this way. Now, you see here base 1 by 2, here also base 1 by 2. Because base lies between 0 to 1 means I can eliminate that logarithms and it is a decreasing function. Hence, x square minus 6x plus 12 less than or equal to 1 by 2 whole power minus 2. Why I have written only 1 by 2 to the base 1 by 2? Because here base 1 by 2 is there, I have written here also base 1 by 2. Suppose here 5 is there, I must have taken log 5 to the base 5 only here also. That is, in that case, it will log 5 power minus 2 to the base 5. Because here base 1 by 2, I have written this logarithm in terms of base 1 by 2. Now I can write. I hope you can understand this. Anyway, I have explained this one also. If the product of the roots of this equation is 1 by bth root of a, where a comma b are natural numbers, then a plus b. See here, it is of the form n is equal to a power x, therefore x can be written as log n to the base a, or even if you take logarithms on both sides also, you will get same thing. I will use n equal to a power x. That is 3 by 4 into log x to the base 2 whole square plus log x to the base 2 minus 5 by 4 is equal to log base root 2 to the x. To solve this equation, what I will take? For convenience, I will take log x to the base 2 is equal to some lambda. Therefore, it will become 3 by 4 lambda square plus lambda minus 5 by 4 equal to root 2 means 2 power 1 by 2, that 1 by 2 here it is. Log 2 to the base x it is, log x to the base 2 lambda, log 2 to the base x is 1 by lambda. Now, here it is LCM is 4, it is 3 lambda square plus 4 lambda minus 5. Here 2 lambda LCM, that lambda will come here, this 2 will go that side. Therefore, it is 3 lambda cube plus 4 lambda square minus 5 lambda minus 2 equal to 0. Now, observe this, it is a cubic equation. By observation, sum of the coefficient 3 plus 4 is 7, minus 5 minus 2 minus 7. Sum of the coefficients is equal to 0 means lambda equal to 1 is a root of this equation. By synthetic division, we will find that root 3, 4, minus 5, minus 2. Here it is 1, 0, 3, 3, 7, 7, 2, 2. Therefore, this equation can be written as lambda minus 1 into, here constant term, coefficient of lambda square. It is 3 lambda square plus 7 lambda plus 2 equal to 0. Again, roots for this will be there. Lambda is equal to 1 is a root, and for this 3 lambda square plus 6 lambda plus 2 equal to 0. 3 lambda into lambda plus 2, 3 lambda plus 1 into lambda plus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, lambda equal to minus 2 and lambda equal to minus 1 by 3. What is lambda? Log x to the base 2. It is equal to 1. Log x to the base 2 equal to minus 2. Log x to the base 2 equal to minus 1 by 3. Therefore, what is x in this case? 2 power 1. X in this case 2 power minus 2. X in this case 2 power minus 1 by 3. Now, all are positive only, therefore clearly these x log x to the base 2 is defined, these are the roots. Now, product of all these, therefore product of all these is 2 into 2 power minus 2 into 2 power minus 1 by 3. It is equal to 2 power 1 minus 2 means minus 1 minus 1 by 3, 2 power minus 4 by 3 is equal to 1 by cube root of 16, that's all. It is of the form 1 by bth root of a. What is b here? B is equal to 3 and a equal to 16. It is equal to 1 by bth root of a. A 16, b 3 means therefore a plus b is equal to 19 will be the answer. See here, it is an equation. They have given product of the roots of this equation is 1 by bth root of a, where a comma b are natural numbers, then a plus b 1. Because it is of the form n equal to a power x, x is equal to log n to the base. For our convenience, to solve this equation, I have taken log x to the base 2 equal to lambda. Therefore, it is 3 by 4 lambda square, and this log root 2 means 1 by 2 will come here, log 2 to the base x. Because log x to the base 2 equal to lambda, it is 1 by 2 into 1 by lambda. Simplification, it is a cubic equation. By observation, 1 is a root. By synthetic division, lambda minus 1 into a quadratic, you can split that middle term, and the roots of this are 1, this equation minus 2 minus 1. Don't think that these are the roots of this equation. For this equation, roots means I need values of x, not for lambda. What is lambda? We have chosen log x to the base 2. Log x to the base 2 can be 1 or minus 2 or minus 1 by 3. Therefore, on this x equal to 2, 2 power minus 2, 2 power minus 1 by 3. Yes, all are positive only. 2 power minus 2 means 1 by 4, 2 power minus 3 positive only. And now product, if you take, this came as 2 power minus 4 by 3. I wrote in this form 1 by cube root of 16, where these two are natural numbers. Now they are asking sum of them is equal to 9. In today's class, we have seen problems and logarithms. mostly no simple basic problems we have seen how to solve an equation, logarithmic equation, and to find solution of that one, and we have seen 2-3 inequalities also. In the next lecture we will be solving some more problems on logarithms only, but of course different models. Till then, take care and thank you.